So I've always been very interested in activity. So when I started as a physiotherapist at Queen's University long ago, I was very interested in how to merge the world of physiotherapy and women's health and physical activity. The goal really is to improve the lives of Canadians by reducing risk of cancer, potentially lowering the risk of a recurrence of cancer or cancer coming back by intervening with lifestyle, and also helping people cope with their cancer treatments through activity and healthy living so that therefore they can recover from their treatments well and sort of return to their usual lifestyle more quickly. The CFI support has been instrumental in allowing me to take this work forward in that it provided equipment that we needed that was vital to this research. So they provided a system where we can measure people's physical activity levels, so very important for our research to show we've actually changed physical activity levels. So we can measure that through a metabolic cart and some exercise equipment, a treadmill and a bike. And as well, they allowed us to look at body composition very effectively using this gold standard method. It's called the BOD pod. It looks like a gigantic egg, but it allows us to measure body composition very accurately. The value of something like the Navigator that can make partnerships between academic research and industry is really interesting in terms of moving this field forward in my mind, because there's a lot of other things we could do, maybe getting tissue samples from people that I think if we could find an industry partner who was also interested in the same ideas might help us with just different methods, different things we hadn't thought of in terms of measurements we could do. Already we've met with a group who are very interested in adipose tissue and understanding different aspects of that, which is also a big interest of mine as well. So our new study that we have going is going to be able to get some adipose tissue samples from people. And so meeting with industry, they had great ideas of how to maybe help us separate the adipose into different cell types and things that we hadn't done before. So I think it's potentially a great collaboration, and they want to know more about the tissue samples they sometimes use, which they never can get. So in a study like this, they may get more information about age and, you know, body composition levels and things like that that may help with their research as well.